CYLP.
What's going on, disciples? Sit back and relax while I take you through this journey of the evolution of direction. Choose your own path.
I gave you fair warning. Beware, beware, beware. Gave you fair warning, beware, beware.
What you thought punk shit was sweet, now you can't sleep. Gotta keep your eyes open wide and hide your face from the streets. I'm like the beast with a warrant, far from a Norman. Gave you fair warning, now you wanna stand squalling. I'm calling out any rapper that I doubt. Smack him in the mouth, throw him in the yoke, boom, then I knock him out. No doubt, Freddy Fox foul, 20 shot, auto Glock plow, Benny Blanc, Porter Rock style, with a twist of...
Okay, now, this particular t-shirt right here is the first shirt that I actually ever had made. Local company where I'm from actually pressed these up for me. I just went and got a basic. I went and told them to put my logo on a basic white tee. Let me try to zoom in so y'all can see this. Yeah, so it was my my logo on a basic white tee, and what I did was, once I got those made, I passed them out to, like, you know, my friends and some of my family, just to let them know, you know, that I'm finally doing what I said I was gonna do as far as, you know, starting this line. And I don't remember how much I paid for them, but yeah, this was my very first design that I had pressed up. And you know, once I started, you know, getting more comfortable with, you know, getting them made, and I had like a few different other color variations made. I had a red version made, I had a black version made, and you know, I wanted to try to, you know, start to do other things on my own. So I started doing more research as far as, like, you know, how do you press up and make your own t-shirts at home. So I figured out that, you know, you needed some special type of equipment and so on and so forth. So I'm gonna show you guys. I bought some equipment and I started making one color design shirts, and this was one of the shirts that I came up with. We made your logo on it. Let me try to focus this up. Yeah, that's the New Britain CT. We made you one from T. This is the first T that I made at home, you know, once I figured out what equipment I needed. So I started making those at home and selling a few of those and giving a few of those away as well. Now, don't get me wrong, you know, when I first started off, I was messing up, spending a lot of money and messing up a lot of t-shirts. But like they say, with you know, consistency and, you know, drive, anything was possible. And eventually you'll get better as long as you keep practicing that something. So when it came to, like, the multiple color garments, that gave me problems. I couldn't figure that out. So, you know, I started, you know, reaching out, you know, to different vendors and presenting different designs to them, and seeing, you know, how much it would cost and, like, the type of material they were offering and, like, how the garments would come out with my logo on them. So I got this Drop Gems. This was let me try to get this more into some better light for you guys so you guys can see this. This Drop Gems design right here, Now I designed this, right? But I had a manufacturer make it overseas because I wanted to pretty much see. There's my logo inside. Let me focus up. I wanted to see the quality of the actual material and actually see how much it would cost to actually make this this actual t-shirt. So when I got it, you know, I was thrilled with how it came out and so on and so forth, but I didn't like the numbers they were quoting me as far as what quantity I had to get made and how much it was gonna cost to ship. Granted, I forgot to show you guys something. That garment tag, everything about this tee, look at this garment tag. I designed that as well. And that's screen printed on there. So when it came to like color designs, let me refocus. That's the first color design that I came up with. All right, so as you can see, I started to evolve, I started to grow. I started to, you know, make more connections with vendors overseas and so on and so forth. And I just kept it moving. Now, Actually, they made this one particular t-shirt for me. And I said, you know what, let me do some more research. Eventually, I figured out how to do multiple colors on garments myself. Now, when it comes to multiple colors garments, people, the more colors you have in your design, the more money it costs to make. Remember that. So keep that in mind when you're coming up with these designs. The more color you add to the designs, the more it's gonna cost to manufacture them, and if you're making them on your own. So, moving on. The great DCYOPT, just a standard logo, letters. I started pressing these up too. Just my logo on a gray tee, 100% cotton. I like to keep all my fabric 100% cotton. Started doing those in the house. Let's move along. This is one of my newer designs that we major T with the barcodes. Simple, white. I think that thing came out pretty clean. It's nice and fresh. Another thing is, I got my hang tags on them joints. Everything look real professional. Here's my garment tag. 100% cotton, boom. Yeah, here's another one of my new concepts. The YOCYOP design. I had some fun with that one. If you don't know where that concept came from, man, you had a terrible childhood. Nah, just kidding. I mean, just do your research. Well, you know what? Let me just fill you in real quick. Boom! There it is. One of the posters I got up in my design room in my house. Moving along, it's another one of my new t-shirts. To hear no evil, speak no evil, see no evil joint. I had the patch made. I'm sure if you've been following me, I told you this already. I had the patch made first, and I got the patch sewn on by my tailor. And yeah, do you get it? If you're gonna be making, if you don't know how to sew, and you wanna, you know, get real fresh on them and make some unique pieces, get yourself a tailor, you know. But when it came to like the screen printing, I did that in house. It's a nice t-shirt right there. That design came out tough. Okay, now this actually right here, this disciple tee, that military green joint right here, this actual t-shirt right here, that's a woman's cut. If you see the collar on this t-shirt, see how wide that is and thin right here in this area? It's because it's a woman's cut. Because a lot of ladies always ask me, you got anything for the ladies? You got anything for the ladies? So, you know, I just pretty much try. I try my best to come up with designs that, you know, fit both men and women. But since I'm not a woman, I mean, I don't know what type of fit you guys like and so on and so forth. So I got to do like a lot of question asking and stuff like that to try to see, you know, what's the best cut and what's the best fabric that y'all like. You already seen this design, but anyways, the OCYOP with the woman's cut. Use some light over here. Yeah, it's the woman's cut. OCYOP. Tell by the collar. And this is the woman's cut. See no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. Now those are just the tees, right? I got a few things as well that I never released, but since I'm doing this video, I might as well show you. Okay, the tank top. It was supposed to come out this summer, but you know, things happen and I wasn't able to release them, but there's always next summer. Might not be able to see that. It's not white, it's actually teal. So just know next summer I'm gonna come hard body with the tanks. Alright, let me see. Yeah, here from this angle you can see that it's teal, it's not white. Alright. Now moving along. The first hoodie I ever made, and it was received well. You guys show me. Oh, sorry. You guys show me a lot of love on this hoodie right here. That red joint. Now, I got these made locally as well. I mean, you guys loved them. It had the path chosen on the back. Then eventually, I started freaking them and putting people's names on the hood. So I sold a lot of those. I like to say thank you for everybody that purchased those. And then once I, you know, saw how, you know, everybody started loving the hoodies, I said, you know what? I love hoodie myself, so let me come up with a new design. And that's how this came about. That black and white future legend joint. Now, when it came to this design right here, I designed this myself, put the future legend, excuse me, on the front, path chosen on the sleeve, white and black stripes on the wrist and the waistband. I got this hoodie made overseas as well. I sent them the artwork. I only got 12 of those made just to see, you know, what they were gonna do and if they was gonna sell. Sold out immediately. You know, people were mad that they couldn't get one, but you know, I mean, it was what it was, man. It was just, I had number 3 on the sleeve. I mean, I didn't know how you guys were gonna receive them, so I just, you know, I sold what I had. I didn't make any more of these either because I wanted that to be like, you know, an exclusive design that I made to say, okay, listen, the next time I make something, y'all better jump on it because it's not a game. I'm starting to get serious with this. But I got a story to tell y'all later on about that Future Legend logo anyways. Let me move along. Then, you know, I went and I started making some crewneck. Another variation of my logo. This was my gray, red, and black logo. Direction, choose your own path. If you notice in the beginning when I was getting these sweatshirts made, my actual logo was not inside the garment. And that's because, you know, I didn't really know anything about having, you know, your name inside the garments or what you had to do in that aspect of the game. So I just did more research and I learned. And that's when I started, I designed my own garment tag. And that's when I started, you know, ordering custom material. And on some of my pieces, I actually put all the garment tags on myself. You guys seen this? This is when I started jumping in that chennile game. That letter D concept was the first one I made. That's pretty tough. Zip hoodie in black, 100% cotton. Excuse me on my focus if I'm messing up. I'm walking back and forth. It's just me. You know, I'm a one-man army right now. Yep. Got my tag in there. I did not sew this on. My tailor sewed that on for me. But I designed a D. Then these came about. Boom. Then we made your hoodies. Now, once again, I designed the chennile patch on the front first and sent them to a manufacturer overseas because it's cheaper. I'm just gonna keep it real with y'all, it's cheaper. Sent it to a manufacturer overseas, got those pressed up, and ordered some custom hoodies, some the material and weight and so the GSM that I wanted, the particular weight of the hoodie. And once I got them, I sent all the hoodies to my tailor, and my tailor actually sold the patch on the front of them for me. So that's the navy blue one. Then I did a custom black one for myself. I didn't really want a lot of people to have the black one because, you know, I wanted to be exclusive with the black joint. I mean, when you're the designer, man, sometimes you gotta save some things for yourself, you feel me? So that's the black joint. This is one that I did for a family member. That Giants blue. Boom. That Giants blue. Woo! Man, that came out good. It's not a game over here. So y'all see, man, how I just evolved, man. And this is just all it took was a thought. Now, this next piece I'm very, very proud about. It changed everything. And that's my 1990-something joint. Boom. There it is. If you didn't get one of these, you wildin'. Just know I'm about to release the new color soon. The hella gray. But I came up with this design. Once again, this is another hoodie that I had manufactured overseas. I told them the GSM that I wanted, the type of fabric that I wanted. And they sent me back a sample. I checked off on it, said, yep, that's good. And they shipped me the quantity that I wanted in bulk. Now, the more you buy, the cheaper the price is gonna be. And I really, really want you guys, if you're really trying to get into this game, and I'm telling you, it's hard, but then again, once you start learning stuff and doing all your research and doing all your work, it's so, so rewarding, man. My wife asked me the other day, she said, why you always get so excited when you see people wearing your clothing? It's like, because I still, to this day, I can't believe that I did that, that they weren't something that's mine. You know what I'm saying? So, moving right along. Yep, this was another, I skipped this one. That was a heather gray, we made your crew neck joint right there. Joint tough. And I just want y'all to know, there's a few things, right, that, you know, I've ordered samples for and I just never released them. And it's because something didn't actually feel right about them, or I did not think something was right about the actual piece. So I put a halt on it, or I just said, you know what, I just told the manufacturers, listen, I'm gonna come back to this one because there was something about the samples that I didn't like. So, and you can do that. If you get a sample from these manufacturers and you don't 100% like it, you can tell them, like, listen, now this ain't it. I want something different. Go back to the drawing board. And these things take time. They could take like 40 days, depending on how the amount of, you know, items you're ordering and stuff like that. So just be patient. Tell your customers to be patient, and everything will work itself out. With that being said, like this jacket I had made, this DC YLP jacket. Now, I designed this, and don't get me wrong, this jacket is tough. It is, it's tough. Got the suede up on the shoulder. Let me try to focus this on. Yeah, the suede up on the shoulder. That's real suede. It's not a game. I'm not playing. That's real suede. This DCYLP patch right there on the left chest. That's real suede. But when I got it, the fit wasn't right. So, you know, it was like, it's more like that European fit. And I'm not with that. I don't like that real tight. So I said, so you know what? I said, listen, let's go back to the drawing board. I'm going to revamp that one. And before I have you guys manufacture those in bulk, let me just change a few things. So that's that. And my see no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil, yellow 100% cotton zip hoodie. You already know about the patch. Got the metal. Where are we at? Focus up. Got the metal aglet tips on the strings. Do all that in house. Garment tag, as you know, as you see, all that's done in house. And obviously my tailor sews on the patches, and then I present them to you, and you guys rock them however you want. Now, can't forget about the custom DCYLP hat I had made, designed this myself, sent it out to the manufacturer, told them what I wanted, told them the material I wanted, and boom, came back. The hat is freaking phenomenal. I'm very, very proud of this as well. It's like a lot of people say, sky's the limit. I don't believe in that. Your limit is your own mind. The extent your mind will take you when you're very, very passionate about something, you wouldn't even believe it, man. You wouldn't even believe the outcome of some of the things that your mind will come up with when you're passionate about something. Why do you think these artists or whatnot, these musicians, they make so much music? Some of the music we never even hear, because they have so much. You know, they're more passionate about some and others. So some of them put things out and they hold on to things and they come back to it years later and say, listen, well, I made this 5 years ago and I could have put it out, but I didn't because of this. And you're like, man, to me that was great, but to them, you know, it wasn't. So you know, keep creating, man. Use your mind. Keep evolving. As you see, I got those DCYOP slides down right there. Now, I like the slides, but there's some things about the slides I didn't like. So I had to revamp those as well. When they came, I didn't like the feel of them. If I don't like the way they feel on my feet, I'm not gonna sell them to the people. You know, I'm not, I'm like one of the realest designers you guys will ever meet. Because I know how I used to feel when I would go out and I buy something and I'm like, man, oh, this look good, but it just don't feel right. I feel like I wasted my money. And I don't want people to feel like that when they buy my, you know, my pieces. So yeah, just know here, yeah, I do have some slides. Eventually I will put them out, but once everything is right, and that takes time, baby. So there you go. You know, I wanted to show you guys, you know, the evolution of my brand. Oh, I forgot a few things. You know, I made a few BMX jerseys as well. I got so much, I can't even keep up with some of this stuff. I got so much stuff. Yeah, so there's the one of the DCYOP BMX jerseys I designed. Submitted that as well to a manufacturer overseas, and they got those done for me. Yeah, they put the labels on themselves over there too, so that was fine. I told them to do that. And here's the other colorway right there. So there you go. Make sure y'all stay with me. Like I said, be on the lookout for those heather gray 1990 something hoodies. They gonna be so tough. When I tell you they gonna be tough, they gonna be tough. Don't sit around and try to wait. Wait for your income tax to come in, cause them bad boys gonna be sold out. I'm telling you right now, it's not a game. But anyways, as usual, thank you guys for watching. I mean, I'm sorry about all the shaking of the camera and stuff like that. All the focus messing up, but you know, I'm a one man army, you feel me? So I'm always going to keep it 100 with y'all. I'll keep you in touch with, you know, my latest garments that I got coming out. And we'll just take it from there. All right, till next time. Choose your own path, baby. Why don't y'all go create something, too, and stop playing?
The message is always in the cloth, the colors, the designs, the fit. Basic. Pay attention. Stay alert. And remember, choose your own path.